Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in today's video, we are going to see how the current sources can be used by using FET. We know that the various biasing techniques that are used for BJT cannot be used for integrated circuit because it requires large surface area for the fabrication process. Therefore, for integrated circuit, the current sources are used for providing the biasing. In this topic, we are going to see how we can implement the current sources by using the FET circuit. So let's begin with the topic. To understand current sources by using FET, we require to consider a circuit which is nothing but, in the circuit, M1 and M2 are the two E-MOSFET. The circuit is similar to the circuit implemented by using BJT. The only difference is that the BJT is get replaced by the MOSFET. Now here, the drain and gate source terminal of M1 are connected together so that it always operate in the saturation region. And we assume that the value of lambda is equal to 0. Now, in this topic, we are also going to see how to find out the current relationship. In order to obtain the current relationship, let's assume that the gate current are equal to 0. That is, IG1 is equals to IG2 is equals to 0. Now, the reference current is nothing but the drain current, and it is obtained by using a relation, that is, I reference is equals to drain current as we are considering the MOSFET M1. So it is ID1, which is equals to KN1 into VGS minus VTN1 square. Now the same equation can be rearranged in the form like so the equation can be rearranged in order to obtain the value of VGS. VGS is equals to VTN1 plus square root of I reference divided by KN1. Let's give this as equation number 1. Now, if we want the drain current to be independent of the drain source voltage, then it is required that the MOSFET must always operate in the saturation region and lambda is equal to 0. Therefore, the output current can be given as output current is nothing but the current flowing through the drain terminal of MOSFET M2. Therefore, ID2 is equals to KN2 into VGS minus VTN2 the whole square. The VGS for both the MOSFET is remain same. Therefore, we can substitute the value that we have find out in equation 1, that is the value of VGS, into this equation. So, we obtain output current as if M1 and M2 are exactly equals to each other, then we can say KN1 is equals to KN2 is equals to KN and VTN1 is equals to VTN2 is equals to VTN. Therefore, the output current equation becomes, now from this equation, we can say that the output current is equals to I reference. As the gate current is equals to 0, that is IG1 is equals to IG2 is equals to 0, therefore the output current is equals to the reference current. But it is possible only when both the MOSFET having equal characteristics. If the width to length ratio or the aspect ratio of the both MOSFET are not equal, then the output current become not equal to the reference current. So in that case, we need to consider the aspect ratio of the MOSFET. And in that case, the output current equation is given as so the output current becomes width to length ratio of MOSFET 2 divided by width to length ratio of MOSFET 1 into I reference. As the aspect ratio are not matched with each other, therefore the reference current becomes not equal to the output current. This relation is possible only when both the MOSFET having equal characteristics. So this is what about the current relationship of current source using FET. So I hope you understand the topic of current source using FET. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda. Subscribe Ikeda. Thank you.